We will start Dalton's atomic theory now. Basic postulates of the Dalton atomic theory is that matter is made up of extremely small individual particles called atoms. Atoms of the same elements are identical in all respect, whether they are in mass, density, shape or size. Atoms of different elements are different in all respects. Atoms are the smallest unit that take part in chemical combinations. Whenever a chemical reaction takes place, in that only the atoms undergo the reactions processes. Atoms of two or more elements combine in a fixed ratio to form compound atoms. Atoms can neither be created nor destroyed during any physical or chemical change, and this is your law of conservation of mass. Chemical reaction involves only combination, separation or rearrangement of the atoms. There is certain limitations of this Dalton's atomic theory. It has failed to explain the law of gaseous volume. It could not explain why atoms of different elements have different masses, size and valencies. It could not explain how and why atoms of different elements combine with each other to form molecules. It failed to explain nature of binding forces between the atoms in a molecule. There is no satisfactory explanation between the ultimate particles of element and that of the compound. So to remove these limitations, we are having modern atomic theory. According to this theory, atom is no longer considered to be individual. It can be divided into subatomic particles, which are known as electron, proton and neutron. Atoms of the same element may not be similar in all the respects. Atoms of different elements may have similar one or more properties. Atoms is the smallest unit which take part in a chemical reaction. The ratio in which different atoms combine may be fixed and integral, but may not always be simple. For example, I have given here C12H22O11. It is not the simple whole number ratio, but it is fixed and it is integral ratio. So atoms are combining in a fixed and integral ratio, but not always a simple one. Atoms of one element may be changed into atoms of the other element. The mass of atoms can be changed to energy by the formula E is equal to mc square, where m is the mass of the atom and c is the velocity of light. In this way, we can convert the mass of an atom to energy. Then here we are having the Avogadro hypothesis. Avogadro hypothesis means without experiment, whenever observation is there, then it's become a hypothesis. Under similar condition of temperature and pressure, equal volume of all gases contain equal number of molecules. Yani ki V is directly proportional to N. More the volume, more will be the number of atoms of the number of molecules or the number of atoms present in it. And if the volume is low, the number of atoms will be less. The smallest particle of an element which may or may not have independent existence and take part in a chemical reaction is called atom. So this is another definition for atom. It is no longer individual particles, is no longer a smallest particle, but it is the smallest particle of the element which may or may not have independent existence and that take part in a chemical substance. But the smallest particle of the substance capable of independent existence is called molecule. So hydrogen is present in the form of H2, that is molecule. It has an independent existence, whereas hydrogen atoms will not have an independent existence. Now, molecules are of two types, homoatomic molecules and heteroatomic molecule. If the molecule is made up of only one type of atom, like oxygen, two oxygen atom is there, two nitrogen atom is there. In ozone, there are three oxygen atom. If they are made up of only one type of atom, they are known as homoatomic molecule. If they are formed by the combination of two or more atoms, they are known as heteroatomic molecule, H2O, two hydrogen and one oxygen is present. Then we are having atomic mass. It is the number of times an atom of that element is heavier than the atom of hydrogen. If we compare any atom with the mass of hydrogen, how much time it is heavier or how much time it is larger than hydrogen is known as the atomic mass of that atom. And now with respect to carbon 12, it is the average relative mass of an atom of an element as compared to the mass of the atom of carbon 12 taken as 12. Okay. Now here it is one atomic mass AMU. It is the quality of the, or we can say it is the quantity of the mass equal to 1/12 of the mass of the carbon atom, and 1 AMU is equal to 1.66056 into 10 to the power minus 24 gram. We have to find the average atomic mass, and for finding the average atomic mass, we are having the two formulas over here. If the atomic mass is given in the percentage, then it is average atomic mass is equal to mass of the isotope A and its abundance plus the mass of isotope B and its abundance upon 100. And if the masses are given in the ratio form, then the average atomic mass will be equal to atomic mass of A into abundance plus atomic mass of B into abundance upon sum of their ratios. Gram atomic mass, it is the quantity of an element whose mass in grams is numerically equal to its atomic mass. If I say atomic mass of oxygen is 16, and when we express this mass in gram, then it will become gram atomic mass. So gram atomic mass of oxygen will be 16 gram. Gram molecular mass, a quantity of a substance whose mass in gram is numerically equal to its molecular mass. The molecular mass of oxygen is 32 AMU. So the gram molecular mass of oxygen will become 32 gram. Now here comes the mole concept, and mole is defined as the amount of substance that contains the same number of entities as the number of atoms present in 12 gram of carbon 12 isotopes. And we know that one mole is equal to 6.022 into 10 to the power 23 particles. The moles can be converted into number of particles in the liters or in volume, or it can be converted into mass of the substance. The relation between one mole is equal to 6.022 into 10 to the power 23 number of particles. It will be equal to 22.4 liters of volume, and it will be equal to the mass of the atom or the mass of the molecule or mass formula. One mole of atom will be equal to 6.022 into 10 to the power 23 atoms, and it is your gram atomic mass of that element. So one mole of the atom will be equal to mass of element upon atomic mass. Mass of one atom will be your atomic mass upon 6.022 into 10 to the power 23. One mole of a compound is the mass of the compound upon its molecular mass. So mass of one molecule will be equal to molecular mass upon 6.022 into 10 to the power 23. If I talk about one mole of a gas and convert it into liters, so one mole of gas will be equal to 22.4 liters. We have another formula to find the number of moles, that is given mass upon molar mass, or number of moles is equal to number of particles upon Avogadro number. Given mass upon molar mass is equal to number of particles upon 6.022 into 10 to the power 23. Here we are having percentage composition also, and the mass percentage of any substance can be found as the mass of that element in one mole of the compound upon molar mass of the compound into 100. So it gives the mass of each element expressed as the percentage of the total mass. Now we are having chemical formula. Chemical formula gives the presentation of a molecules of a substance in term of symbols of various elements present in it. We are having two types of chemical formula. One is our empirical formula, the other one is our molecular formula. Empirical formula is a simple whole number ratio of the atoms of various elements present in that one molecule of the compound, whereas molecular formula gives me the actual number of atoms of various elements present in one molecule of that compound. The relation between empirical formula and molecular formula is that molecular formula is equal to N into empirical formula, and to find this M, we are having molecular mass upon empirical formula mass. And here I have given found the empirical formula. For this, we have to make this table. This is your elements in a compound, that is C and H. They are present in the compound in the percentage of 92.4%, and 7.6% of hydrogen is present in that compound. The atomic mass of carbon is 12. The atomic mass. The empirical formula is found by taking the moles of the atom. Now, number of moles of the atom is by the mass, given mass upon its atomic mass. So here given mass is in the form of percentage. It is 92.4 upon 12, that is 7.7, and 7.6 upon 1, it comes to be 7.7. Then we take the mole ratio. Mole ratio will be the ratios divided by the smallest ratio. In these two cases, the smallest ratio is 7.6. So 7.7 is divided by 7.6 and the answer will be 1.0. Again, 7.6 is divided by 7.6, so it is 1. So the simple whole number ratio will be 1 into 1. This means carbon in simple whole number ratio is present 1 and hydrogen is also present 1. So the empirical formula becomes C1H1. Now we have to find the empirical formula mass of this empirical formula. Carbon mass is your 12, hydrogen mass is 1. So here 1 atom of carbon is there, so 12 into 1 plus 1 into 1, that comes to be 13. So the empirical formula mass will become 13 gram. Let the molecular mass of that compound in which 92.4% of carbon and 7.6% of hydrogen is present is 78. To find the molecular formula, we have the formula as N into empirical formula mass. So here N is equal to molecular formula upon empirical formula mass. So here 78 upon 13, that comes to be 6. The value of N becomes 6. 6 into empirical formula C1H1. When we multiply it, it will form C6H6. So how many number of atoms of carbon and hydrogen are present in that compound? That is 6. So actual number of hydrogen and carbon are 6, but the simple whole number ratio is your 1. So here, this one is your empirical formula, whereas this one is your molecular formula.